Think you're avoiding harmful chemicals just because you eat organic or buy non-GMO foods? Well, I've got news for you. Glyphosate, the active ingredient in Roundup, is everywhere. And I have even scarier news. Since there is so much news about the harmful effects of glyphosate, savvy big agricultural companies are switching over to an herbicide called Diquat. It's now being used as a secret replacement for glyphosate. And it's only used in the United States. It's been banned in all other countries, including the EU, including Canada, because it's so dangerous. And I'll talk more about that in a bit. But today I'm going to walk you through 10 foods with some of the highest herbicide levels. Now, trust me, this one's going to surprise you. So first, let's take a look at what is glyphosate. And perhaps more dangerously, what is Diquat? So glyphosate is the most widely used herbicide in the world. It was originally developed to kill weeds without killing crops. But in order to do that, companies like Monsanto, now owned by Bayer, genetically engineered crops like corn, soy, and oats to resist glyphosate's effects. Sounds pretty clever, right? Well, the weeds fought back. We now have what are called superweeds, weeds that also resist glyphosate. So, what do farmers do? They actually spray more of it than ever. But here's the part they don't tell you. Glyphosate was actually patented as an antibiotic. So it doesn't just kill weeds. It also kills the good bacteria in your gut, especially the ones that produce serotonin, your body's feel-good hormone. And yes, glyphosate has been directly linked to leaky gut, mitochondrial dysfunction, anxiety and depression, and even certain cancers. In fact, a 2019 analysis from the University of Washington found that glyphosate exposure increased the risk of non-Hodgkin's lymphoma by 41%. And here's the kicker. A recent CDC study found that more than 80% of Americans, including 87% of children, had detectable levels of glyphosate in their urine. Even babies are being born with detectable glyphosate levels. And bad news, it transfers to them from the mother through her breast milk. So if you're wondering whether you've been exposed, you most certainly have. Now, let's talk about the herbicide that scares the socks off of me, Diquat. I call it son of Paraquat. Paraquat was an extremely effective, dangerous herbicide that had so many side effects, including neurotoxicity, that it was banned for use. Well, not so fast. You can take the chemical structure of Paraquat, change it a little bit, and call it Diquat, and use it as a very effective plant killer, herbicide, weed killer. So why is it so dangerous? It's actually more dangerous than glyphosate. Couple reasons. It kills off your gut microbiome. It's a neurotoxin. It causes leaky gut. And because of this, it's banned in all countries except the United States. Why are they using it? Because you don't know about it yet. And so they may be cutting back on glyphosate. They may even start labeling glyphosate free, but they're using this instead. So why do they use this in the first place? Crops have to be harvested at a certain time, because big agriculture has these huge, expensive harvesting machines, and they can't wait for the end of the season for instance, corn to dry up and harvest. It's much easier to harvest a dead plant than a living plant because there's no water. So to control plants being harvestable, glyphosate, and now Diquat, is sprayed on these plants to kill them so as a desiccant, so they dry up. So you can schedule one of these expensive machines on soybeans or wheat or oats or whatever on one field one day, and then the next field the next day will be ready. So the good news is they're not GMO anymore. They're regular plants, but because you're so worried about non-GMO, they can spray all of these things on non-GMO crops, but they're still going to have high levels of glyphosate or diquat. Now, this is a common practice in modern agriculture. And I take care of a lot of big farmers, and they say they cannot practice modern agriculture and make a profit without doing this. Now, here's the bad news. They're not washing off the glyphosate or diquat after they harvest. They're not being kind. So let's go through the top 10 foods where these chemicals show up the most. Oats. Now, even the organic brands. In one study, every oat-based product tested contained glyphosate, even granola bars marketed to kids. Number two, wheat, including bread and pasta, crackers. Non-GMO means nothing here. Remember, these agents are used as a drying agent. Number three, corn. 90% of U.S. corn is treated with glyphosate or diquat. And that includes corn-based snacks, oils, and sweeteners. Soy, same story here. 90% of soy in the U.S. is sprayed. And yes, that includes soy protein in plant-based meats. Now, chickpeas and lentils are often sprayed to speed up harvest, and these are found in many vegan products. Breakfast cereals, Cheerios, granola, oat-based cereals, they've all tested positive for glyphosate. Really bad news, apple and cherry juice. Now, fruits grown near sprayed weeds absorb glyphosate, and it ends up in the juice. Dates and dried fruit. Now, dried fruit gets hit hard. Almost 65% of date crops are sprayed with glyphosate. Here's the bad news, wine. Now, glyphosate is used to kill weeds between grapevines. Now, many wines, even some organic wineries from California, have tested positive for glyphosate. Number 10, conventionally raised meats. Now, here's the bad news. Because animals are fed grain that's been sprayed, these herbicides builds up in their tissues. So when you eat the meat, you're eating the herbicide too. Now, I know this sounds overwhelming, but there are real practical steps that you can take to reduce your exposure. And studies show that simply removing the biggest glyphosate offenders from your diet can start improving your gut health, energy, and mood in just 3 to 7 days. Okay, so here's where to start. First of all, choose organic produce and products when you can. Shop at farmers markets and ask about their practices. Please, please, please avoid processed cereals and granola bars. They're often the worst offenders. Wash your fruits and vegetables thoroughly. No, it doesn't remove everything, but every little bit helps. When you're buying wine, look for organic, biodynamic, or European labels. France and Italy have stricter standards. And consider adding glycine to your routine. Now, glycine is one of the four amino acids that form the step ladders in the double helix of DNA. So let me explain how glycine works. It's one of the four amino acids that make up the rungs of the ladder in the double helix of DNA. Now, unfortunately, glyphosate looks a lot like glycine. And so it can replace glycine in your DNA. That doesn't sound like a very good idea. Now, the theory goes with taking lots of glycine, you basically flood the zone with glycine. So you'll always have plenty of glycine to fill the ladders instead of glyphosate. Now, here's another reason I take glycine. Glycine and N-acetylcysteine, NAC for short, makes glutathione. Now, glutathione, you may remember, is one of only two antioxidants in our mitochondria. Now, despite what you hear, you cannot swallow glutathione. Glutathione drips or waste money and time. But consuming glycine and NAC together allows you to manufacture glutathione. So you get a 1-2 punch. You flood the zone with glycine, you make glutathione, which protects your mitochondria, and you limit the effects of glyphosate. Now, interestingly enough, the other antioxidant in mitochondria is none other than melatonin, the sleep hormone. Believe it or not, melatonin may be the actual reason why the Mediterranean diet is so good. It may not be the polyphenols in the Mediterranean diet, which, don't get me wrong, are phenomenal, but melatonin-rich foods. For instance, wine is rich in melatonin. Olive oil is rich in melatonin. Mushrooms are rich in melatonin. And the highest melatonin-containing food, pistachios. So eat your melatonin. Lastly, please, please, please don't use Roundup in your yard, ever, especially if you have kids or pets running around. Now, here's an idea. If your yard is overrun with weeds, have a weed-pulling party. I know you're not going to believe this, but I grew up having weed-pulling parties as a family activity. We would once a week go out and sit in the yard and pull weeds. We actually talk to each other. This avoids using a weed killer and builds a better community and family. It's a win-win. But here's the sad truth. You can't avoid every toxin, but you can make smarter choices every day. And when it comes to glyphosate, or now diquat, even a few simple swaps can make a real difference to you and your family. So take a look at what's in your pantry. Flip the box over. Ask questions at the market. And don't fall for non-GMO labels. Thanks so much for watching this episode. But don't go anywhere. I think you're going to love this next one. So today, I want to walk you through 10 common cleaning products that could be silently hurting your health. And what to use instead.